This video will show you how to set up and program your Intermatic ST01 or EI600 astronomic timer in standard mode. The first step is to perform a factory reset to clear the memory. This is especially important if you're switching modes. Press and hold the on-off button and then use a paperclip or similar object to press and release the reset button. Continue holding the on-off button until you see INIT for initialize on the display. The next step is to select your language with the plus or minus buttons. For this example, we will choose English. Confirm by pressing the on-off button. Now choose the timer function. You can set it to standard operation or make your ST01 a countdown timer. Use the plus or minus buttons to make your selection. For this video, we will keep it at standard and press the on-off button. To begin setup, press the mode button. You will see setup on the display. Enter setup mode by pressing the on-off button. Now use the plus or minus buttons to choose the current hour, being mindful of the AM/PM setting. Next, press the on-off button and choose the current minute. Confirm your choice with the on-off button. Now select the year and the month and finally the day of the month. After pressing the on-off button, you should see the current day of the week. Confirm this with the on-off button. Now select the daylight saving time setting for your area. For this example, we are in a part of the country that observes daylight saving time, so we will choose auto. Select your time zone next. You can choose between Central, Eastern, Atlantic, Newfoundland, Hawaii, Alaska, Pacific, or Mountain Time. A list of these time zones is available in the included instructions. We are in the central time zone, so we will advance to central and press the on-off button. Now choose your country. We are in the United States, so we will select USA and press the on-off button. The next step is to input your latitude. Don't panic. This can easily be found using the map feature on your smartphone. Drop a pin at your current location and scroll down until you see your coordinates. You can also find your latitude and longitude with a simple internet search. Another way to find your coordinates is by scanning this QR code, which is also located at the bottom of the included instructions. A list can also be found on the ST01 product page of our website. Please note that decimal points will not be shown on the ST01 screen, so 42.2 should be entered as 422 and will be displayed as 422. If you find coordinates with no decimals, for example 42, the ST01 will still need a number to the right of the decimal point, even though that decimal is not displayed on the ST01 screen. So 42 will be input as 420. 48 will be input as 480. Putting in 042 or 048 will result in incorrect longitude and latitude settings. First, input your latitude. Include three digits, with the last digit being the first number to the right of the decimal point. Then input your longitude. Again, include three digits for longitude, with the last digit being the first number to the right of the decimal point. Press the on-off button to confirm your choices. Based on your location, the correct time for dawn should now be displayed. You can offset this by up to 99 minutes with the plus or minus buttons. But for this example, we will keep the current time for dawn and press the on-off button. Now the correct time for dusk should be displayed. Again, we will keep this setting and press on-off. Now that setup is complete, we can start programming the timer. Press the mode button until you see program displayed. Enter this mode with the on-off button. For programming, you can select from three different templates. T1 sets the timer to turn on at dusk and off at dawn. T2 sets it to turn on at dusk and off at 10 p.m. T3 is on at dusk, off at 10 p.m., and then on at 5 a.m. and off at dawn. A list of these templates is included in the written instructions and can be downloaded on the ST01 page of our website. For this example, we will skip these templates with the plus button and set a custom schedule. You will see 01 displayed on the screen, indicating that you're setting the first custom event. Press on/off to enter. With the plus or minus buttons, choose if this is an on or an off event, if you want to skip this event, or if you want to erase what's been programmed. For this example, we are setting an on event. Confirm by pressing the on/off button. Next, you can select dawn, dusk, or a specific time with the plus or minus buttons. For this example, we will choose dusk and then press the on/off button. Now select which days you would like this event to occur. You can choose all days, individual days of the week, Monday through Friday, or weekends. For this example, we will choose Monday through Friday. Press the on/off button to confirm the days and save this event. To set a new event, press the plus button while the event number is flashing. You will see 02 displayed on the screen, indicating that you're setting the second custom event. Press on/off to enter. For event number 2, we will have the timer turn off at a specific time. So choose off and press the on/off button. To set a specific time, advance through dusk and dawn with the plus or minus buttons until you see a time displayed. Now press on/off to set the hour. For this example, we will choose 11 p.m. Now press on/off to set the minute. We will use the plus button to advance to 11:15 p.m. Now press on/off to choose the days for this event. Again, we will select Monday through Friday and then press the on/off button to confirm the days and save the event. To set a new event, press the plus button to advance. If you're finished programming, press the mode button. Your display will return to the current time. Auto mode allows all pre-programmed schedules as well as manual overrides with the on/off button. Press the mode button to advance to random mode, which will adjust the programmed on and off times within plus or minus 15 minutes each day for security. Manual mode disables any programmed schedules and only allows operation with the on/off button. For this example, we will press the mode button to advance through setup and programming modes to return to auto mode. And you're done! You've successfully set up and programmed your Intermatic ST01 or EI600 Astronomic Timer in standard mode. And if you have any questions or need help at any step in the process, you can call or email technical support at the contact information listed on the screen. And be sure to check out our other videos on YouTube or visit our webpage for more tutorials.